Hi, and welcome to Workflow from Home, a mini-series dedicated to exploring the tools and techniques designed to help professionals investigate workflows within the cloud. My name is Michael, and like you, I am also working from home. I think it's important to point out that the entire workflow that we've deployed to make this video series is completely centralized in the Frame.io cloud. We're feeding the camera takes directly into Frame.io. We're editing off a platform in the cloud integrations of Final Cut 10. We're doing graphics and effects through our integration with Frame.io in After Effects. We're uploading raw files and conforming and coloring with the Frame.io integration in Resolve. We write the scripts in Quip, and then we message each other in Slack, and we have a dozen people collaborating on the edits in Frame. Because the entire Frame.io team is working from home, this is actually pushing us to lean on Frame.io in the cloud even more. And that's one of the reasons we want to share with you how centralizing your world in Frame.io can make workflow from home a success. So in this episode, we're going to take a look at how to begin setting up a team for a cloud-based editorial workflow. Now, what I mean by team is a group of editors who've been used to working together in, let's say, a brick-and-mortar setup using on-site shared storage, like an Avid Nexus. This setup might also be useful for people configuring cloud workflows in visual effects pulls and conforms and music cue auditions and even color correction. But before we get this going, the good news is that there's dozens of tools and technologies that have emerged in the remote collaboration space. So this episode is in no way meant to be a comprehensive analysis of every potential cloud collaboration solution. Instead, we're focusing on several readily available and hopefully easy to understand concepts about better leveraging the cloud in your world by highlighting just a few of them. If you have suggestions for other tools and workflows you think that we should investigate, please share them in the comments so that we can bring those resources to the community as well. When a production begins to explore options for working from home, the first thing that's important to understand is that there are two major categories of how cloud workflows actually work. A pure cloud workflow leverages the cloud for most or the entire part of the workflow process, and a hybrid cloud workflow, which leverages the cloud for some key portions and leans on local storage for others. So how are these two different? Well, a hybrid workflow accesses some, but not all material from the cloud. It requires above average internet speeds for optimum performance. It requires a more powerful computer workstation because computations will be done locally. And a hybrid workflow enables some workflows to remain partially air-gapped. A pure cloud workflow requires that remote users have total access to all material through the internet connections. This works with average or sometimes even below average internet speeds. It requires an average computer workstation or even a laptop because most computations are done remotely. And it requires that a collaborator is online all the time, so it's not ideal for workflows that require air gaps. One of the workflows that DI and sound facilities are engaging in is limiting their workforce to as few people as possible, which means some employees are local and the clients are remote. This means facilities may be able to keep their vaults going, and access to high-speed networks allows you to centralize your media, which can be an ideal foundation for customizing a secure hybrid or pure cloud workflow. When it comes to security, you're looking for tools that are TPN certified, which basically means that it's certified by the Trusted Partners Network. You're also looking for compliances with SOC 2 Type 2, which basically means there was a known third-party audit to document all the safeguards of a tool in terms of confidentiality, privacy, availability, and security. It's also important to have the option to support session-based watermarking, which helps keep assets secure when they're shared outside of your Trusted Partners Network. Security is a top priority for Frame.io, and we've made it a cornerstone of our platform, earning us several top international awards for cybersecurity. So let's talk about bandwidth. Bandwidth is a big question that everyone's probably asking themselves. And the question may be, do I have enough bandwidth necessary to even do this? That's a good question. The answer is easy to test, and we'll use a formula to determine whether a hybrid cloud workflow is even possible for you at home. So let's get started. First, the easiest way to test your bandwidth is to go to www.speedtest.net. This website accesses your network performance. I have fairly average home internet using Spectrum Ultimate. So when I perform a speed test, my bandwidth is about 200 megabits per second download or about 20 megabits per second upload. That's roughly 25 megabytes per second down or 2 megabytes per second up. So what does that actually mean? Is it enough to work from home? Well, that depends. The next question we have to ask is, what codec are you working with? Most collaborative edit teams are editing on the Avid platform with either DNxHD 36 or DNxHR LB, or on the Final Cut 10 or Premiere platforms using ProRes LT or ProRes HQ. With the formula here, if you're working with 1080 material in DNx, the bit rates average about 35 megabits per second. Based on my home internet bandwidth, that means I can download approximately 1 minute of footage about every 7 or 8 seconds. An entire hour of DNxHD will download in under 10 minutes. For ProRes LT, I can download 1 minute of footage about every 15 to 20 seconds. An hour of ProRes LT will download in under 20 minutes. So when it comes to typical HD dailies, I can download about 50 hours of DNxHD media in 8 hours, or about 30 hours in ProRes LT in 8 hours. In an ideal scenario, you have access to a facility vault mainframe that can get off the shelf hard drives and transfer your media onto that so you can work at home remotely off a drive. Most of the friends I've checked with are still operating their post-house vaults. But in the event you don't have access to a working vault or you're preparing to work from home, consumer home internet bit rates are capable of downloading close to 100 hours of efficiently encoded dailies in 24 hours. The most important data point for anyone exploring a hybrid cloud workflow is that your internet download speeds exceed the bit rate of your file. Generally, that should be the case. If you're looking for an even more efficient way to work, and you haven't rendered all your dailies, you could explore transcoding to HEVC instead of DNx or ProRes. HEVC runs roughly 3 times smaller than DNx or ProRes for visually the same quality. So you can download 200 hours of media encoded in HEVC in about 8 hours. That means network speeds aren't necessarily the barrier that they used to be. The barrier is actually HEVC in native support. Some NLEs chew through it without issue, others do not. So a test is in order. When it comes to working with media, Frame.io is unique in that it's designed to support all Avid DNx codecs and Apple ProRes codecs natively, as well as H.264 and HEVC natively in the platform. Frame.io can act as a high-speed media shuttle tool, and you can drag and drop and securely shuttle any type of file to any number of recipients. In addition to moving assets, you can play them natively in Frame.io as Avid or ProRes files. That opens up an opportunity for you to use one asset in multiple ways. For example, if we uploaded all the DNx edit material, because it works natively in Frame.io, a director or producer can review, comment, and share an Avid asset as if it were a web daily. This saves on storage, it reduces the total number of assets, reduces upload time, and centralizes your media into one place. For optimum efficiency, you don't need to render an additional set of smaller web files for viewing cloud dailies because Frame.io will take Avid and ProRes files and automatically transcode them in the background to make them streamable on all devices. So the same Avid DNx file that can be sent to an editor to cut with is the same file that can be streamed easily on any mobile device in several smaller resolutions. Let's say that I want to review this asset when traveling and I don't have internet access to my mobile device. I can make it offline and watch it without a network connection. If I want to edit locally with the same asset, I can click on the DNx file, select download, choose original, and now I have access to the MXF media. If I have a department using Final Cut or Premiere, which doesn't use MXF media, I can choose to download the 1080 AVC file, and now I can edit directly with that asset instead of needing to create an entirely different file for departments that prefer QuickTime MOV files. All of these functions can be performed with a single asset upload into Frame.io in the cloud, which makes the media management required to serve multiple departments much more flexible. Preparation. What can content creators do to prepare their assets? Well, every production deals with varying types of media, varying totals of terabyte volume, and varying numbers of collaborators. Some tools already have built-in solutions for cloud editing that fall into the pure cloud workflow category. Here are a few examples of how to help a team of Avid editors work in a remote environment. First up, Teradici. Teradici is an excellent solution for people with a pure cloud workflow. It allows a remote, real-time, low-latency review because in a pure cloud-based edit system, both your NLE and your media are living in the cloud. Your local computer is simply an access point to those resources. To log into Teradici, you'll need the IP address of the system you're trying to access and security credentials. In this use case, I'm accessing the cloud through my MacBook Pro, and the edit system is an Adobe Premiere system on a Windows installation offsite. Note that if you're using it in Avid, you'll need a Media Composer Cloud VM or Media Composer Ultimate license. The beauty of a pure cloud system is once you've accessed your workstation, whether Avid or Nuke or Premiere, the NLE workflow is the same as if you were at your place of work. That said, most IT or engineering teams use disk imaging at large post houses to quickly install new edit stations when required. So make sure to use the latest image when virtualizing so the media is correctly referenced in the appropriate folders. If this isn't possible, there will be an additional setup time to locate and link the media. A pro for Teradici is that it's platform agnostic. It works on Windows or Mac, and since your computer at home is really just an access terminal, it doesn't require a lot of processing on board. It also works well with low latency on home wireless connections. One potential drawback is that it may require IT or engineering setup support, which is a bit of a challenge when you're working from home. And low latency doesn't mean no latency, which increases by 1 to 4 frames of audio sync over standard home wireless networks. So here's a little recap of the key points we've just covered. First, remote workflows can now be designed to serve all aspects of post-production from editorial to final delivery, which starts by centralizing the source. When moving a team to a remote workflow, you'll need to first determine whether or not you want to work in a completely cloud-based environment or if you need a hybrid environment. That will allow you to change the way in which you're going to access your local storage. Frame.io works natively in Avid with DNX and Apple ProRes codecs, which makes it simple to not only manage and move assets, but also to use Frame.io as a high-speed transmitter, a transcoder, and remote dailies viewing solution. Hybrid cloud workflows may require higher powered workstations and faster internet speeds than pure cloud-based workflows due to the need for processing locally. But it's easy to test your internet bandwidth to determine whether or not it's adequate for a remote workflow that you're using. Thank you to everyone who has provided suggestions on topics to cover in this series. And if you found this information helpful, please let us know. We're trying to explore a number of solutions for professionals who are interested in a workflow from home, and we'd love to hear from you. Let us know what you want us to cover more of, and please share your questions. We're all in this together, and we hope some of the information here is useful to the community.